What it was Toronto. Ed Conroy of Retrontario joins me on a regular basis, and we talk about the recent history of Toronto and some of the things you might not realize had started here. And Ed, you were telling me that the advent of 24-hour television happened in part here in Toronto, you know, with 157 channels on your television going 24 hours a day. Some people might not realize that the television used to not be a 24-hour deal.
That's right. It was, you know, they would play the national anthem sort of after midnight and then put on color bars and, you know, you'd go to bed. And this was a moment in Toronto history that I think is really important. It was a series called The All Night Show, and it was only on for 1 year, but it was the very first in all of North America all night program that actually programmed the middle of the night. And it had a great theme song.
Hey, you, crawl out of your hole. You're getting too old. You better stop rocking it and not knocking it. Yeah, you, what you trying to do?
Yeah, that was by a local punk band that was called The Start. And Hey You was the host of the All Night Show's catchphrase. And the host was this guy known as Chuck the Security Guard. He was actually a stand-up comedian by the name of Chaz Lothar. But the conceit of the show was that it was on Channel 47, CFMT. The idea was that everyone had gone home and shut down the studio, and the security guard came into the broadcasting room and started to take over the cameras and take over the feed.
This is an SCTV type
totally.
Thing.
Totally. Yeah. Before SCTV. So right. It started in the fall of 1980, so almost, you know, 38 plus years ago. And it went off like a bomb. Like, Toronto had never seen anything like this. So, you know, they're showing The Twilight Zone and The Outer Limits and, you know, Car 54, Where Are You? And these kind of old shows. But in between the shows, they had this guy, Chuck, the security guard. And he would sort of go on adventures, and they'd have people come in. They'd have bands come in. So, like, David Wilcox would come in, and people like that would come in and play live. And, you know, this is before MTV, before Much Music. They were showing music videos. They're showing experimental films. And really, it was the brainchild of this guy who you might have heard of. His name is Jeff Silverman. He now runs Yuck Yucks.
Yeah.
So he had, you know, at the time in the 70s, Jeff was running the Horseshoe. And he also ran the Roxy and the New Yorker in Toronto. So he had access to all kinds of weird footage. And, you know, they would fill up the slot sort of between midnight and 6 a.m. with all of this great stuff.
Was this just a weekend show?
No, it was every night.
Every night?
7 nights a week.
The security guy never went home.
No. You know, everybody else went home, and he came in and took over the airwaves. And, you know, they did things like they would show like a goofy old movie and they'd redub it, or they would have commentary. You know, things like Mystery Science Theater 3000, which gets, again, all the cred. But the All Night Show, sort of outside of Toronto, not a lot of people knew about it until YouTube came along and people started posting clips, because they had, you know, a lot of incredible talent worked on the show. But two of the voice artists who got their start, one was a fellow by the name of Maurice LaMarche, who you might know from Futurama, and he's done a lot of cartoons. But the other one was Jim Carrey.
I heard of him.
Yeah, you might have heard of him.
I have heard of him.
He got pretty big.
Uh-huh.
But what they used to do was, do you remember that old cartoon called Clutch Cargo, where it would be like an animated face, but there'd be human lips moving? And this, of course, went on to be a late night staple on Leno and things like that. But they pioneered it. They would get these black and white pictures of famous historical characters, and you'd see the lips moving, and it would be Jim Carrey doing the voice of Nixon or, you know, whoever they were poking fun at. And, you know, it absolutely exploded. A lot of, you started to see bands wearing All Night Show t-shirts. Everybody would say, "Hey, you," because that was Chuck's catchphrase.
Hey, you, welcome to the All Night Show. I'm Chuck. Ryerson's driving the camera, literally.
Good morning, good morning.
And here we are, Bob Dylan singing about Highway 61. And we'll show you the video theme, and then we'll come right back and tell you exactly what's going to be happening tonight.
So that was, his sidekick was called Ryerson. He was a Scottish guy, but you never actually saw Ryerson. He was behind the camera. And in real life, that was played by a guy named Errol Knapp. And he was a DJ on the pirate radio ship Caroline in the UK. You might know that
story.
And the All Night Show kind of was like pirate radio because it was run like that. It was this whole idea that it was illicit. It wasn't supposed to be happening. So
like the boss didn't really know they were doing it.
Exactly.
And night after night, he never figured it out.
Well, they would go into his office and mess around with papers on his desk.
Okay.
And then they also had this other amazing guy named Michael Lennick who would do a lot of video special effects. And, you know, they would do sort of color screen overlays, things which, again, became a staple of what you now see in late night comedy television. They pioneered all that. Lennick went on to work in some David Cronenberg movies doing special effects. And unfortunately, the show got canceled 1 year later. So it only existed for 1 year. But in that 1 year, they chalked up, you know, thousands of hours of this amazing content, which thankfully is now some of it's online. There's even a Facebook page for the All Night Show where a lot of the people that worked on it are still there and they'll answer questions about it. And, you know, I'm sure some of your listeners that are old enough to remember, they'll get excited about this because this is something that just was like a jolt to the city. It was like after that, everybody said, oh, we can run content in the middle of the night. People are going to watch it.
Is that part of what killed it? Everybody else caught on. We've got to run some programming on, even if they were just running movies, et cetera.
I think that was a big part of it. I think the other issue was that CFMT at the time was a very small station. It's now known as Omni. It was a multicultural channel. They didn't have a lot of money. And because the All Night Show got so huge so quickly, I think it would have cost a lot more to do it. And they just said it's probably cheaper to run Car 54 without the security guard, you know, doing the intros and outros.
Well, it could have been that by the time he did it for a year, there was so much overtime they owed him because he was doing security during the day and then he stayed and did this overnight thing.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Yeah. It was
either that or Jim Carrey priced out.
Yeah. Well, Jim Carrey was still, you know, for quite a while after the All Night Show, he didn't get huge till the 90s, really.
Yeah, yeah.
But, you know, one of the things I don't remember, and I was too young, but the day John Lennon was shot, you know, the All Night Show had to go on that night. And one of the great segments they would do is they would phone payphones, because back in the day, payphones had numbers. And they were just phoning payphones around the world the night John Lennon shot and talking to random people who were saying how sad they were John Lennon got shot.
So, wow. That's great programming.
Amazing show.
Yeah. All right. It was called The All Night Show.
The All Night Show. Hey, you.
All right.